speak to the audience and don't worry about them.
Hello, my name is Gregg Moree, and I've lived in Cambridge for 50 years. I'm a lifetime resident, and I went to Ranger and Latin and the Pixie schools. And affordable housing, jobs for the youth of this community, and the battle over rent control is over, but we need to push on for more affordable housing for the people of this community. I know that the elderly are waiting in the nursing homes and senior centers, and like my mother waited, she's 75 years old and she waited to get into a senior center. I just didn't like that. And I know there's a lot of seniors out there waiting to get in the senior centers. So we have to do something about that. Affordable housing, jobs for our youth, the youth apprenticeship programs, pushing them into the building trades, electrical, plumbing, residency requirement must be mandatory on these construction jobs. Our kids are not getting the jobs in the city that they deserve. I don't believe, the reason why I'm stepping up to the plate, but I don't believe that the politicians are pushing these kids into the unions, and they need to be pushed into the unions. And so I'm that person to push these kids into the union. I'm a union carpenter myself for 22 years. I know that this stealing jobs from the city of Cambridge, the politicians have got to push these kids into the unions, electrical, plumbing, carpentry, painting, get them off the street, or they're going to be statistics. And I'm Gregg Moree, and I'm asking everybody for their support and the next city council race. And I'm the nephew of Joseph Sankey. Thank you. I'm a lifetime resident. I live in North Cambridge. I believe in honesty is the best policy. I live on Fairfield Street. I support youth apprenticeship programs, civil rights. I support immigration. I remember my grandparents when they came here, the way that they were treated. And I support a new fresh breath of air at City Hall. St. Mary's Church right across the way there, that's my church. My grandfather founded it in 1928 with a handful of families that came together and they founded that church. It's the St. Mary's Church there. I look for your number one vote. Thank you very much.